A stalemate in Albuquerque tonight as tensions rise between the administration and the unions that represent most city employees. They have been working without contracts.
New at 10, Action 7 News anchor Tanya Mendez explains why this affects everyone in Albuquerque.
Real, we're talking about everyone from police officers and firefighters to mid-level managers and those who pick up our trash. Union leaders and their members are angry and say the city is anti-union. The city says it's being responsible, and it all comes down to money. It's a matter of dollars and cents to the city of Albuquerque. If the city doesn't have the dollars for raises, then they don't make sense.
Some of these unions have wanted 5, 6, 7%. That's unreasonable in today's economy.
The city council appropriated enough money for 1% raises for all union employees who make less than $50,000. That's it.
We have to be good stewards of the taxpayers' money.
And the chief administrative officer of the city says over the past 8 to 9 years, when it comes to union pay, they haven't been good stewards. In some cases, employees got 20% raises. The city sent these letters to the unions last week, saying now that the contracts are up, so are the hefty hikes in pay.
It's difficult to assess how long it would take to reach a consensus agreement.
Adding fuel to the fire is the fact that union bosses are paid by the city even when they take time away from their jobs to handle union business, a practice the city says is over.
We're not going to pay $300,000 a year to have 7 different union bosses who don't do their jobs within the city.
Rob Perry says the unions should pay their own leaders, and until they agree, the city won't budge.
We're not going to be able to pay union bosses to be bosses with the taxpayers' money. We're not anti-union. We're pro-city taxpayer.
I called representatives of 6 of the unions that represent city employees for their responses. Only one responded. Fire Union President Diego Arancon directed us to a statement he posted on the Fire Union website that says, quote, many of our current elected civic leaders have gone too far by pushing a generic anti-union agenda rather than honoring long-established labor management practices. Andrew Padilla with AFSCME told our media partners at the Albuquerque Journal that he believes the city's actions violate evergreen clauses that keep union contracts in place until a new agreement is reached.
The city says they will allow union team members to take unpaid leave to handle union matters.